37 high schoolers boarding the Fisherman 3 in Point Loma are among the hundreds of students across the country participating in rigorous science camps this summer. But these students come from 15 countries in Latin America, and unlike all of the other science camp participants, they're getting their lessons in Spanish.
Pero hay uno por aquí. There's a lot of science camp in the United States, but most of them are in English. And so our idea was if we made this in Spanish, then we could have kids from every economic strata, not just like separating the ones that spoke English with not. And so that's what we tried to fulfill, and you actually see it.
Most of the kids were chosen for the camp by their country's American embassy. They had to submit essays and go through interviews. Embassy sponsorships and scholarships mean none of these students had to pay for the two-week camp. And the campers appreciate just how rare an opportunity this is.
First, when they told me I got an interview, I couldn't believe it because I was happy. And then when they say that I won, it was awesome. Really.
There are opportunities that only present themselves once in your life, and this is one of them.
Patricia Moore is an instructor working with the students through their two-week stay at the Institute of the Americas at UC San Diego. She says they ask more questions than many of the community college students she teaches during the school year.
Can you imagine? It's just some of the students, they have never been in the ocean. And they get a sister, for example. And you grab the sister and you see the face of this student looking at the sister for the very first time. To me, that's all. It's payday.
Jailene Mamani Poma is one of those students who was blown away by her introduction to the Pacific.
My country doesn't have ocean access. So the first time I saw it was the most beautiful. And we saw it from a dock. It was beautiful.
When the boat pulls up to bait docks in San Diego Bay, it's clear the students are here for the science, not just a neat trip.
Who's gonna pull it?
The crew scoops up muck from the bay floor for them to examine, and they jostle to get closer. Ramirez says the boat ride and visiting tide pools and the aquarium have just made him want to learn more about the ocean.
This is como que impresionante que nosotros.
It's amazing for us, and there's so much ocean here for discovering what we have. All of these plants here, the biodiversity, the changes from one area to another. There's so much to keep learning, of course.
Hay muchas cosas que me gustaría seguir y seguir profundizando en eso, claro.
Access to diverse marine environments is just one of the things that makes San Diego the perfect place to introduce students to a variety of scientific topics, says Lee Tablewski.
We've got great science scholars here who love to talk with students. We have the wonderful ocean that's around us that gives us a great classroom, and we have great resources like Qualcomm and the San Diego Zoo that really embrace us and invite us in to talk about innovation and to talk about things like the California condor.
The two-week camp is about more than fun trips, though. Students are working in small groups back in labs at UC San Diego on research and innovation projects. Vasquez says her group is designing a portable blood test.
It's quick, it's efficient, and we are working on that. And for science, we are doing an experiment on water of the different countries, and we are analyzing the bacteria named coliform.
Mamani Poma says one group of researchers that talked with the students about memory and the brain have her reconsidering what she wants to do with her life.
Just everything they said, that everything is connected in one space. The brain is a very big container. So these words made me change and say, this is what I want to learn. And how the brain is still, we don't understand very well all of the ways it works. I said, I want to discover one of the ways it works.
Moore says the camp can be one small but important step down the road to a career studying the brain or in any other scientific area.
I have been telling them, it's important what you are going to learn, but more important is the relationships that you are having here, the connections with the people that live here, because you never know, you are going to go back to your country and you need references, for example, so you can contact us. This is what they are gaining, the communication with the scientific people.